Hello, Dota 2 fans, and welcome back to Chicago Tech with another episode of the Golden Aegis cast series. This time around, it is going to be replay ID number 16287626. So thank you very much for the donation. Look forward to getting to your game, and I hope you enjoy the show. So for the rating this time around, it's Take My Life on the Spirit Breaker with Spider-Man playing the Wind Ranger.
Everybody gets set. 5S
going to be on the Naga Siren with Mr. W on the Tusk, and Your Soul is Mine playing the Blood Seeker. Meanwhile, for the Dire team, it's AC on the Templar Assassin with Schneedust playing the Keeper of the Light. Alice will be on the Clockwork with Hobo Pig on the Faceless Void, and Blood Berry playing the Tide Hunter. So starting a little bit early on this one, let's get to some important bits about this game. It looks like Dire or Radiant are hanging out by both runes. In fact, they should be able to get both of them. The Dire playing this one very back here, not even worrying about either one of them.
Every
so Spider-Man will
helps.
Get the first rune, the bounty. Mr. W waiting on the bottom bounty rune. In fact, looks like he wants to give it to 5S on the Naga Siren, and it should go his way. So the Radiant starting with a very nice amount of gold in this game for an advantage. The Dire, well, they are a little bit behind to start this one out, but I don't think they care. AC went for the block, so he should have a little bit of an easier time versus Wind Ranger, but this is a very tough lane for the Templar in and of itself. I mean, given the circumstance, you're looking at a very good range hero versus a kind of iffy early game range hero. And TA can dominate the lane, but doesn't really have anyone to dominate. You can't really do too much with that TA. So Take My Life now on the run. They should be able to bring him down. They charge of darkness is out of this one. Now Your Soul is Mine. Going to take the brunt of the damage, but actually looks like they both get away well enough alive that it doesn't really matter. I mean, Take My Life only has the three tangos. No salves in this off lane, but they should still be all right. Meanwhile, Alice is bullying out 5S, just trying to gain some advantage on this lane, but Your Soul is Mine. Can they get the bash off? All they need is a bash. They don't even have it, but they do have damage. They just need one more right click. It comes out. First Blood will go to Schneedust. And Bloodberry now underneath the tower. The Charge of Darkness will keep him in for a short amount of time. Maybe they can get the kill their turn. Take My Life. He just got to get the last auto attack, but he can't get it off. Very unfortunate that they weren't able to get that return kill there, but and the Radiant are quite happy about that one. At least one lane, or the Dire, I guess, are quite happy about that one. At least one lane will be going well. The off lane should also be going pretty good, but it'll make up for the mid lane, which by and large shouldn't be going all that great. Now they could grab Take My Life. They got a couple of bits of damage off. They will finally bring him down. Now Bloodberry taking the tower damage. Real Soul is Mine will also go down. They're splitting aggro very effectively. Schneedust will also get the aggro off of him and make his way through the forest. So a double kill for this Dire safe lane, and they're just being super aggressive on this, and they're not caring at all. This is how you really go after a dual off lane here when you're a tri-lane. You just get so aggressive on them. Double damage on Schneedust, though. Take My Life. Should be able to bring him down. Just looking for one last right click, but can't find it. Now Schneedust, though, is down quite a bit of HP, which is giving a good chunk of HP damage and movement speed to the Bloodseeker. In fact, Bloodberry as well will give a lie. He was trying to deny to a neutral group, and he gets it. Take My Life, not getting the kill fast enough. And Schneedust, they had a salve for him, so he'll get away alive. Oh, boy, that... that was very, very unfortunate for the Radiant side. They didn't get the kill off. They've been losing three up on this top lane. And I might lose more. All they need is a bash. They'll go out with the mana leak. And now they slow him down with the Gush, the Maya's Armor. They'll go forward with the Time Walk. They just need a bash, but they can't find it. All they need is the bash, but still nothing. Time Lock just not being on his side right now. It is only a 10% chance, so I guess not hitting it makes sense. But Alice now chasing on to Mr. W in the midst of all the creeps, so it looks like Mr. W should be able to juke away from this one. The battery assault only lasting for a short amount of time, though Alice, he does have cogs at the ready if he wants to go ahead and lock W in. It looks like, though, he's not going to spend it for now. Instead, waiting, he'll pop him out of him. 1 second for the flare, but it's not enough damage. Mr. W will go for the salve. Top lane again, though. Bloodberry looking still for these bashes that just aren't coming out. Take My Life. He actually doesn't have greater bash skilled, so at this point, I suppose Tidehunter getting away is not as, you know, unlucky as Spirit Faces Void not getting either bashes. So looking out the mid lane, we kind of see what we expect. Windranger is dominating this one as far as CS goes. AC does have her bottle out and about, though, so I guess she looks for ganks as her main source of income. Because the lane, or at least wait for Windranger to gank so that you can take the lane, but you just don't kill the Windranger. Sneedust actually will go down behind the tier 1 tower. A very heavy dive, and actually they could lose more for this one. Hobo Pig dropping very low, but Your Soul Is Mine. He doesn't want to let this one get away without a fight. He's got Thirst up, but it looks like Hobo Pig will get himself away in due time. So Schnee Pig going down. That's the first kill, the first actual kill that the Radiant get in this game, putting themselves on the board. Well, the Dire, they now have an Observer Ward past the Tier 1 tower, so I guess that is a little bit of a plus. But Mr. W makes his way on up to complete this to be offensive tri-lane coming out from the Radiant side. Meanwhile, Sneedust pretty much soloing this one up as the two others, Faces Void and Tidehunter, will be making their way in very slowly but surely. 5S now going up, continuing to get bullied by Alice. Now the Battery Assault. 5S could be in a lot of trouble here. Alice can dive under tower for this one, but 5S is just too far away here. The Battery Assault does not connect for one or two procs, and that's all Alice needs to get away. And we're talking about 365 MS clockwork, 370 movement speed for the Naga Siren. So she's moving just a little bit faster than Alice, allowing her to get away at a moment's notice. Meanwhile, there's going to be a tug. Snowball coming out on the Sneedust. Your Soul Is Mine, though, getting slowed up, but moving faster and faster with due time. He will get himself away from the Faceless Void. Now they turn onto Hobo Pig. The bashes, they need him. The Mana Leak comes out, and actually the Illuminate, Your Soul Is Mine, taking so much damage at about 14 HP. Now, with Take My Life going down, they granted his wishes. AC, he couldn't find the kill. He walked right past him. Oh, dear. Oh, no. Mr. W now on a little bit of trouble. The Illuminate will fly through, dealing a little bit of damage. Now, Time Walk forward. Hobo Pig will find the kill. Now, Superman trying to find the kill onto Hobo Pig, and it will get him off. Or get it off, rather, because the other way sounds very wrong. Spider-Man, Superman might also get another kill here onto Bloodberry. He will get it off. AC now chasing him, wants to try to find a return, and this should happen. AC just needs one more right-click to get it. Sneedust, though, will be the collateral. Now Take My Life back in for this one. A Rocket Flare comes out, the Melt Strike out as well, but the Satanic Trap not hitting. Instead, the hook, it will connect on the AC himself. Now Your Soul Is Mine will turn. One, two, three, chop him down, Mr. W, with the pike to destroy him. Now Assault Kuras on the run. Your Soul Is Mine will chase with Thirst. No more double damage, though. And it looks like the Radiant will hold off for now. Looking out for the Tier 1 tower. Though a 6-for-6 at this point in the game. Neither team the clear winner of that engagement, though the Radiant at this point have absolute free space now for their Naga Siren, who has accumulated 1,200 gold. I wouldn't say this is a naked Radiance. In fact, I'd be pretty worried if this was a naked Radiance, but I'd more expect maybe go for the Assault Kuras here, Boots of Travel out quickly. I don't think actually go for the Boots of Travel this early. Why did I say Assault Kuras? I meant Ring of Akala. Out would be a very great item for her to have. Any sort of regen, any sort of sustain in this lane is also very, very good. Pretty much whenever you've got someone who wants to naked farm an item, that a very big item, like your Anti-Mage for a Battle Fury or your Spectre or Naga for a Radiance, you want something to allow them to keep in lane. Sometimes Anti-Mages will go just the Ring of Health. Sometimes they'll go Ring of Health and Ring of Regen, since you can build both the Battle Fury and Vladimir's off of that. Sometimes Spectres will go Ring of Health just to have the extra bit of HP regen. Maybe go for Van, but that's not really that looked up upon, as while Your Soul Is Mine, we'll find Sneedust. They're looking again for Hobo Pig, but they can't quite find him. Their Power Shot comes through, but it misses. And instead, they want, oh no, Take My Life with Vision. We'll go to Hobo Pig. We'll bring him down. Now Sneedust in a lot of trouble, and Radiant manning up, puffing out the chest and saying, Your Soul Is Mine. They'll bring down Bloodberry as well. A TPN. Alice is looking to turn this one around. He might even get one or two kills off this one. Mr. W will be the one. And maybe he can find a second. He'll walk over the Psionic Trap. They won't pop it, but it does give them vision. Radiant's all he needs is 6 seconds apart to drop a Rocket Flare. Do they know? They know exactly where he is. 1 second for the Flare. It'll fly. It'll hit. And Alice will get a double kill off that one. What the hell just happened? We're now 10-for-10 at 9 minutes. Still 5S with a pretty much free lane to farm. And it looks like because he's got the free lane, I think that's reasoning enough for him to say, well, I'm going Radiance. Screw you guys. I'm getting the burn
damage. Mid tower's getting banged up.
Now Bloodberry will make his way down, though, probably trying to apply some pressure on the Naga Siren, try to slow down her farm, though. All she needs to do, she doesn't have any points in the mirror image just yet, so I guess it doesn't work as well now. But one of the major perks to going for early points in Mirror's Edge, or Mirror's Image, Mirror's Edge is a video game. Schneed Dust with the charge, also with the snowball. This Coddle is not having a great day, but with her going down, maybe there is a silver lining as Hobo Pig is turning around to Mr. W looking for the bass. Alish will find a kill in the 5S in the bottom lane. That's huge! Hobo Pig, he could also go down though with the bash. There's actually a rupture on the AC. They're going to powwow him down, but they're going to try. No, AC's manning up. He'll find Mr. W. Finally, he'll go down. A 3-for-2. But the major kill is a Naga going down the bottom lane. Oh boy, that sets her back a lot. 36 CS at 10 minutes is the maximum on the board. That's actually really low considering this game. Or considering where it could be this game. You've got a Bloodseeker who could easily have 50 to 80 CS right now. You've got a Naga as well who could easily have Windranger could easily have everyone,
Radiant mid tower,
really, who had a solo lane, aside from really your offlane, like Clockwork, Tusk, Spearbreaker, could have 60 to 80 CS right now. Which, I mean, double the CS, 30 CS is worth, what, 1,200 gold? If you consider it 30 times 40, yeah, about 1,200 gold. That's a lot of gold at this point in the game. So, well, no point talking about that now as Alice will go in for the whole kind of take my life. He's trying to get the Nether Strike off, but in fact, he's just giving himself to Alice, saying, come take me, big boy. And it looks like he will. Bloodberry will also go down on behind the Tier 1 tower, making it a 1-for-1 trade in the end, as this is the game of trades so far. 14-13. Shackle shot through the tree. Schneed us once again. The time of his life, I can tell. Although he is barely away for now, Cyberman will go forward and bring him down. Now AC with a rupture. Your soul is mine will come through. They have full vision of him. He'll get brought down. And now Alice, he's looking to do that coveted thing where he turns the fight around, but with the shackle up under the tree, maybe he can't do so. The charge will come through as well. As the cog will drop just before the Spirit Breaker makes his way on in. Now Alice in a whole host of trouble as the charge, the bash, the blood right, the dead clockwork. And Radiant pulling ahead pretty majorly at that little engagement there. Taking down four without losing a single one. Or I guess taking down three. I don't know if they were able to bring down anyone else, but 5S continue to push with 2,400 gold. AC's down, though, and could easily kill this Naga Siren given a little bit of space. Actually, maybe not. Only Phase Bottle, level 9 Templar Assassin versus a level 9 Naga Siren. Still naked, but with the Song of the Siren, with the net, the ensnare, has plenty of ways to get away from a Templar Assassin that is barreling down on her.
Radiant's mid tower's coming apart. Have fun trying to bust down Radiant structures now.
Mid lane, Hobo Pig. Maybe looking for Spider-Man. Radiant's Superman, rather. The tower will get brought down. And now Hobo Pig on the run. Just a shackle shot is all he needs. A lot of damage from this Windranger. Gets the shackle. Now with the focus fire. But it looks like with the snowball might save her life. It won't. As Superman or Hobo Pig will still drop. Alice comes in. And he'll drop as well. Bloodberry comes in. Maybe he'll drop as well. Radiant snowballing so hard with some of these fights. AC now looking to turn it around as Take My Life turn around looking for a couple of hits, but it looks like Take My Life now will go in for the charge and run away with a greater bash apply. The shackle catches both. Now a power shot through, a rupture on the Bloodberry. Blood Ray on the AC. This will get him with Envision. No, it just doesn't. Just barely out of it as Bloodberry does go down. AC now on the run near full. Your soul is mine, can't bring him down any further than he is right now. He'll turn around for the Mellow Strike, but doesn't connect. Now a snowball, and AC is as good as dead. The Radiant all very low. Zeusol now all the flare. Okay, it won't connect. may have been enough to bring down Mr. W, but it doesn't look like it was lucky enough to catch him. Meanwhile, 5S getting dangerously close to that relic. But speaking of danger zone, Alice comes in with the hook shot that caught 5S. He's got a Song of the Siren, but he can't spend it. Now he gets it off, and he'll have to back himself away really quickly. It looks like Alice has given up this kill. No way he can continue chasing without another hook shot. And no Aghanim Scepter to his name either, so he won't have it. Now 5S will get himself away with 3,200 gold to his name. Not a lot of mana, though, so he can't really take any stacks if they had any. But they don't really have any. Meanwhile, a deny on the top lane. A Kronos here will catch more of his team than it does the enemy. Almost killing Bloodberry single-handedly. He'll get tossed up in the ground. Now a Rupture out on the Keeper of the Light. And Schneedust will go down another 3 for the Radiant team. 25-13 at 15 minutes. Oh, God, I almost don't want to look at the graphs, but I will anyway. 7,500 net worth, 7,500 experience for the Radiant side. And, hey, you've got Naga Siren as well. You've got so much extra going your way. Meanwhile, AC with 1,800 gold. I can almost imagine maybe a Blink Dagger is on the menu for him, but at this point, I think he needs to go more utility. Oh, no. That's not good. Another kill on the Naga Siren. We'll drop her to 3,300 gold. Now AC, Meld Strike out. We'll have to go and back himself away, but immediately gets bashed. He'll get brought down. Bloodberry goes in, looking for the Ravage, but he just can't get it off. Dear God, he's taken so much. The Radiant, snowballing so far out of the control this game. Almost an Aghanim Scepter. In fact, we might even have it completed. We do. Windranger with a 16-minute Aghanim Scepter, 10-2-11 at 16 minutes. She has been part of more than a kill per minute with 22 kills with her name on them. 27 in total for the Radiant side. So lots of participation from the Windranger. In fact, we're going to take a look at the total KDAs. And, wrong fire. And it looks like the only one rivaling her, really, is the Spiritbreaker with 18 kills with his name on it. The Tusk has 16. The Bloodseeker has 15. So everyone on the Radiant team, aside from the Naga Siren, are taking part in these kills and getting a whole chunk of gold out of them. And we can take a look. That's probably the majority of why I'm... In fact, if you look at the KDAs, I mean, look at the parallels. I mean, the colors are almost parallel, at least in the top 5 spots, but I don't know. Alice is trying to hook himself out, but there's no way out for him. Mr. W will bring him down. 5S finally being part of a kill here with 3,900 gold to his name. And he can buy the relic now. We'll have to send the courier to the side shop, though, to do so, but...
Guess what's happening?
I mean, getting closer and closer to that radius is exactly what he wants. Now 4,300 gold. Very close to that radiance at this point. So he could probably, if he can get that relic out to him, he might be able to take a couple of jungle camps and then have the full completed radiance out to him within the next 5 to 6 minutes, which, given the relic's out at 17 minutes, not the fastest relic, but still a good relic timing. Yes, say it like it ain't easy. Yeah. Bloodseeker is one of the more hated heroes. Like your face. Oh my God. The call-outs, the shots from both teams. So, as it stands right now, still with more than 2 kills per minute, we've got a call and a recall onto Alice as he comes into the fray. Mr. W will go down, will bring down, get a dominating spree. The hook in, though, for the double cogs. AC trying to go off on this one. But do they have enough damage to bring either of them down? The charge will now come through, and maybe the Radiant look for the turnaround. The Chronosphere flies out, but what is it really accomplishing here? The snowball up, and Mr. W will stun out one, and now Hobo will go down. Mr. W finally getting brought down, but Superman just gets a godlike spree as he's finding kill after kill after kill, and now Bloodberry will go in for the Ravage, but what does it help? He is just dead. It's a 5-man wipe. on the Dire side. The Radiant only losing one. And Keeper of the Light is already back. It just goes to show you how low level everyone is. So,
Dire's mid tower.
19 minutes in.
Them dire
and the Radiant
are, tough as nails
are just
now.
Pulling so, so far time. Ahead in this one.
Dire's mid tower won't last much longer.
Now Radiant Rupture out. Schmied us. Okay. Another death. Another dollar. At this point, he's worth 360 gold, which, you know, okay, I guess.
Hope the dire weren't partial to that mid tower.
Oh, man. That's. I love watching the chat here. In fact, I almost want to leave the chat just open just to give everyone a good idea of what this looks like. It's more than hilarious. So, it's almost going to be as fun as a game, isn't it? So, speaking of the game, Blood Seeker will pick himself up a Blade Mail and a Shadow Blade. Naga Siren with the Radiance fully completed. So you can see her farm start to skyrocket at this point. Tusk, now with a Dagon. Really? Really, Tusk? Okay. So the problem with Dagon is you can't really do all that much with your Walrus Punch, but I don't think he really cares. He's just kind of wasting their time. He will go down, though. And comes Take My Life, a Rupture onto AC, though. Alice should go down. Take My Soul's Mind still wants the Templar Assassin. Just drop a Blood Rite. You should have got the kill. What's okay, a Blink Dagger. An AC will die to the Blink Dagger damage from the Rupture. Yeah. Yeah, it's a one for one. But the problem with that is that your Tusk is going a little too YOLO. Top lane 5S with the Radiance is now destroying Hobo Pig.
Commend me to
death.
Okay, so now Naga Siren is finding solo pickoffs on Faces Voids. And things get it just getting much, much worse by the second. So as it stands right now, we're 36-16. We've had 52 kills in a 21.5-minute game. And it doesn't look like it's slowing down anytime soon. 5S is going to find Alice. He's got a hook shot, so he might be able to get himself away. They need to go ahead and block the hook, but it doesn't look like they'll be able to. He'll hook actually into this one. The Raze Burn will be enough to bring him down. The Snowball in. And Mr. W with the Tusk securing that one. Now AC will get recalled back. But this burn, is it enough to stop it? It is. And with the ensnare, yeah, they that's a dead Templar Assassin. AC going down. Your Soul is Mine. Meanwhile, we'll find Schnee Dust elsewhere. 22 minutes in, and we have another four man down technically, if you count the Faceless Void that died to the Naga Siren solo. And Mr. W has almost surpassed Alice, which is a pretty big deal. As now the top tier one taking some aggression. It's actually the bottom tier one. Superman will bring it down. Going for the Maelstrom after the Aghanim Scepter. I almost kind of like Daedalus over Maelstrom just because the Ags and boosts the damage of the Daedalus. Or at least your Daedalus damage doesn't get reduced by your ultimate anymore. I don't think the Maelstrom ever got reduced by your ultimate. I don't think the damage did. I could be wrong, but I just think Daedalus is actually more damage. You don't need to worry, but you really worry about attack speed with Focus Fire, so I don't know. Either way, the mid-tier 2 tower now might see a Focus Fire, but the Dire are keen to protect it. As it looks like Your Soul is Mine with a Shadow Blade. Schneed us. Okay. 1-2. Rupture. Four staff. Dead. Keeper of the Light. Meanwhile, Mr. W will bring down Alice. And another two dead. Just blink and you'll miss it. Okay, this, yeah.
Dire's mid tower's having technical difficulties.
I love it.
Dire's mid tower.
So I'm just gonna leave the chat on for a little bit as we try to focus on what's going on. I can't click anyone with the chat box. There's an invisible chat box. You can't click anyone on with the chat box, so I guess I will take that away, but It's almost becoming more entertaining than the game. I mean, when you're 41-16, it's kind of like that. It's really kind of like that. In fact, the Radiant, they can just try to push this one and win within the next 5 minutes now. I won't say they've won the game. I've seen crazier comebacks. I've seen games like this come back and end up winning for the other team. But it'll be crazy if it does. So now Take My Life going for a pretty deep YOLO charge into AC. We'll pop a BKB and teleport out. Now Mr. W comes in and will one-shot or at least bring down Schneedust. We'll be on the run, but a four of Faces Void will go for the Chronosphere. Now in Yolsura's mind, they'll bring him down. Two for one in the end. Song of the Siren. A 5S will try to secure his escape with that. Spider-Man comes on in. There's going to be a hook shot in, though. Superman, you're not in the right base. So it looks like Superman will also get brought down. That's a lot of gold that the Radiant just gave up there. So, yeah. This is the peak of Mount Everest. And now we start to see the descent. Now, I don't know if it's going to continue like that. That seemed to be a little bit of a 2-YOLO of a fight for the Radiant. They probably will play it smart from here on out, but maybe they lose Take My Life as well. I mean, he does have it in his name. So we'll turn around and, yeah. So, in the last couple of kills, Mr. W going down, or I'm sorry, Superman going down gave away. Okay, well, never mind. Your Soul Is Mine died first for 977 gold. Superman died next for 1,300 gold. And then Take My Life died for 600 gold. So we're looking at about a 2,800 gold swing off of that fight. And, I mean, we can take a look at the graphs here just to get a good idea of just what that is. And yeah. I mean, even more than that, about a 5,000 experience swing. 5,000 gold net worth swing off of that one fight alone. And I mean, again, the kills, they only show on the one target. They don't show everyone else getting the gold. So Bloodfairy will go down. The Rupture comes through. Alice will come in with a hook shot, but what does Alice do to this? As he'll go down. Now Hobo Pig wants a bit of the action, but the Snowball will protect it from the Illuminate. Snowball comes out. Hobo Pig gets three shot. Now AC on the run. Before have already died. He'll go in the meld. He'll meld strike out, but that only opens him up to so much pain, so much suffering. He'll drop, and now Schneedust will also go down. Another strike to secure that, and another five-man wipe for the Radiant side as they lose no one. Dire lose everyone. And I think the Golden XP Grav will make its way back up again. Yep. Right back up to the north. And what has got to be the weirdest game at 27 minutes I've ever seen. 67 kills and 27 minutes. Keep in mind, 2 kills per minute would be 54 kills. We have 13 more than 2 kills per minute. I don't think I've ever seen a 3 KPM game, but if there ever one, if this game continues to go and neither team actually pushes to win, I could see this being a 3 kill per minute game. Of course, you know, I think the record is like the TI5 All-Star match, which was something crazy like 5 kills per minute, but we won't go there. Instead, Superman will find the Age of Immortal, and now they'll push into the mid lane. They charge another YOLO charge up to the high ground. No creeps are pushing. Okay. So, yeah. AC is just dead. Dead. Take My Life is still alive. The Snowball is preserved. It's a bitter bug here. Chronosphere comes down. Already Take My Life is dead, as well as Your Soul Is Mine. Oh boy, actually a lot of kills for Dire, but they'll lose four in the end. Alice, the only one left standing. And he shall drop very soon. We'll actually bring down 5S. And can Superman actually bring him down? Power shot, no! Oh man, he'll still go for it though. Because why not? That was funny. Superman could probably end the game right here. Or not end the game, but bring down a tier 3 tower. He's got focus fire at the ready. So, with backdoor protection down, keeper with the lights up. But it looks like he's hanging in base because he doesn't want to fight She's got a Crystallis at her back, so a lot of hero damage, not a lot of tower damage. Probably wouldn't be able to bring down a tower, even if all said and done. So 29 minutes, and that'll be the end of that. 53 to 23. Longer. 76 kills. Dear Lord. Dear Lord, that's a lot. Very action-packed game so far. As the Dire, they're struggling to hold on, but the Radiant continue pounding on their door. The last couple of fights, though, haven't really been as effective. They can't seem to fight in the Dire's base, rather. It looks like every single fight that they've taken outside the base, they've won. But inside the base, they've either traded or lost. And that last one, it was more of a 4-for-5, but regardless, the Dire will go back right out to farming. Another snowball. This one, he's just caught in a perpetual snowball. Okay, that explains it. That's funny. Schneedust is actually caught in a perpetual snowball. All right. So it looks like Cottle is rolling in style. He'll pick up all the chicks now, I guess. I think that's how it goes.
Every coin helps.
Something like that. He's got the boots in the Yoga Club, though, and three iron branches. So this is the tankiest Keeper of the Light you'll ever see in your life. All he has to do now is turn two of those iron branches into a magic wand and then go for a bracer to make up the extra space.
Radiant's bottom tower ain't
and you're golden.
Sight right now. No breaking down the Radiant structure.
Or, you know,
like
go
this.
For a mechanism to eat up two of the iron branches. I mean, nothing eats up three
trouble
iron branches
brewing
anymore,
at Radiant's
does it?
Bottom tower.
So, yeah, I mean, you can't build anything for three iron branches. Which is unfortunate. You know, I kind of wish those days when you could build a magic wand out of three irons, but no matter. We'll look past it. As a Dire, they hold on to their base for now. The Radiant, they're gearing up for their push. I mean, there isn't another Roshan for a good long time. I mean, we're 30 minutes in. 5 to 6 minutes. What is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I was right the first time. 5 minutes doesn't seem like a long time right now. But it's pretty long given the game, the pace of the game. It's going to say Snowball coming in, but it's not actually coming in. They're going to chase onto Superman, but they can't quite find their line. Instead, maybe Mr. W looks for his own Snowball. He's got, what is that, a Bloodstone on him? What is his item build? Yep, he'll Snowball into the Snowball, find Sneedust, and we'll bring him down. Now, Rupture onto Hobo Pig, but the Rupture, Ravage comes out. Bloodberry not doing quite enough with it, though, as he gets brought down. Hobo Pig did end up getting taken down as well. Now Alice with a Shackle shot. There is a Blade Mail, so Superman is killing himself, but not fast enough. And it looks like another four-man wipe. As looks like the Dread Radiant can now push a little bit more into the Dire's base. Maybe this time they can actually bring down some buildings. As the Tier 3 fully exposed, Superman comes up with a Focus Fire. The building is pretty much dead. They'll pop a Glyph for good measure. But there's not a lot that can be done about this. And the racks should fall, maybe even multiple sets of racks after this one. So yeah. What? No way. No freaking way. So wait, do the Radiant win? Or do the Dire win? I think someone has to abandon before the Ancient falls. So they may still be fine. What the hell just happened? They all disconnected at the same time, which leads me to believe that they're all at like a LAN center or they're all playing at the same connection. But oh my god. Okay, so Wind Ranger comes back, reconnects to the game. That helps a bit. I wonder.
Radiant's bottom tower seen better days.
Yeah, so So Windranger will push everyone. Micro and Clang Meepo literally. But she'll lose herself. She'll lose take my life. Oh man, this is
Radiant's bottom towers seem better days.
This is just unfortunate.
Radiant's bottom tower is pretty sick.
You'll kill Alice, but your Solas Mai is pretty much dead. Or is he? No, they're going to Hobo Pig.
Somebody's on a roll. Two down.
He's gonna micro wipe the entire Dire team, isn't he? Hobo Pig being there, but he stops chasing with 5S instead. Holding him back for now. So I guess I don't know.
Radiant's top tower's in bad shape.
Oh man. I don't know what to say about this. So yeah, a very unfortunate ending. I don't think it actually ended. I don't know. Maybe they'll reconnect. I still have faith. Of course, this game not over. But this is, it's problematic, but, and it's funny because he hasn't said anything either. Like, at this point, like, he's either completely focused on the game or trying to win it, trying to salvage this win. But there's no way he's ending this game within the time it takes before they someone abandons. And that's the unfortunate part about this one. I mean, we're sitting 2 minutes away from someone abandoning. I don't know. 60-25 at 36 minutes. 1 minute left before a total abandon from the Radiant side. One last pause.
All right, carry on. Radiant's mid tower's getting the what for.
And of course, you know, Radiant, Dire, they gotta go for the trash talk here. I don't quite condone it, but you know, at this point, why not? Game of Dota, half the trash talk. Hook come in from Alice. They want 5S. The Chronosphere will catch everyone else on the high ground. And I think the Dire, if they can play the micro, it looks like they could end up winning this one. And they should. The Ravage comes in. And even that, you can have the perfect micro, and it just won't be enough. Radiant will get nearly wiped. And it looks like, yep, the tides have turned. The Dire now in the commanding position, and the Radiant about to lose to Abandon. Well, I mean, I don't like saying games are impossible at all, but this game is seeming pretty impossible for the Radiant team, so with a 4 Abandon, they actually abandoned at the same time. So, yeah, I guess that's a thing. But, yeah, this game's pretty much over, guys. An unfortunate end to a hilariously action-packed game. But in the end, a bit of anticlimactic way to see this go. But I hope you did enjoy the game regardless, especially before the mass abandonment here. If you want your own replay casted with or without mass abandonment, just go ahead and check the description of this video or go to dotacasters.com. I know at the time of recording this video, it is down for maintenance, but if you're watching this and it's back up and you want your own replay casted, I strongly recommend it for all your live and replay broadcast needs. But in the end, you know, if you like the video, you can go ahead and like, favorite, do whatever you want, the whole kit caboodle to it. This game's still not quite over yet, so got a little bit left to play as Dire will all mass retreat. I'll just go with that little interlude so I don't have to go over it all at the end, and in the end we can just do a clean exit on this one. Windranger still holding on strong, still holding out hope. Though I wonder how much hope she can actually have in this game. Shinidas is about to die to Naga Siren, abandoned Naga Siren illusions. But I guess, in the end, she's alright for now. Windranger will pause again. But the Dire team,
alright, carry on.
They got nothing. And I'm kind of curious as to what. Okay, I don't know what caused the hate, but whatever. In the end, looks like another push down in the bottom lane. A lot of damage going the way of, actually, Naga Sion will kill Shnida, so the abandoned Naga does end up getting the kill. But now she's up ahead without so much of a lifeline. They're going to take my life. He pops a BKB, and he should be able to get himself away from this one. The Ravage comes through. It will catch 5S. Bringing down this Naga could be huge, and it looks very much like they will do so. Two down with no buyback. Hobo Pig, though, will find one. Mr. W will also grab another. Four dead. And another massive fight win for the Dire team. And another chance for the Dire to actually win this game here. Again, a massive and unfortunate turnaround. So, with the bottom racks falling, a Ravage coming out, they want your soul as mine. Doesn't look like they can bring him down, but looks like he actually might grab one. They'll go out with another meld, but it's not quite enough damage. They want to go for the Mega Creeps here. Your soul is mine, you're getting a lot of damage for him. And his way up, looking for kills, has a Blade Mail pop.
The Radiant got one last top tower.
Yeah, so he'll go down. Follow five-man wipe. Mega Creeps will be spawned for the Dire team. And the Radiant, they just have nothing more to fight with. Recalling, what the hell? Shnida's gonna recall back Hobo Pig.
Radiant's mid tower's coming apart.
I don't know. Thank you guys so much for watching this game. Sorry the ending was a little bit anticlimactic, but I'm sure there is a lot of humor to be had in this one. I kind of feel bad for the Dire team. They got so much advantage. But then again, what the hell am I talking about? They have a Bloodseeker picker. They do end up returning this game, but, you know. Yeah, it's a little bit too late. It would almost be perfect if the Radiant ended up winning, because now I don't really feel bad given the amount of trash talk the Dire put out, but it's pretty much over at this point. So, GG, well played. You guys heard all that stuff earlier before, so thanks for watching. This has been Chicago Ted with the Golden Aegis cast series. Of course, they have to delay the game as long as possible when I start my outro. But this game is pretty much over, so I hope you enjoyed, and I will catch you all next time.
Things ain't looking bright for Radiant's Angel. Under pressure. Someone's having technical difficulties. Dire's done it again.